Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. A couple weeks ago, I did a video on magcon, and I talked about how I thought that the whole thing seemed like a fever dream because it was just such a weird point in our lives. Everything about it just seemed fake, to be completely honest. Like, if I hadn't lived through it and I heard about it, I would have gone, that does not sound like it happened. Surprisingly though, one of the most frequent comments that I got in that video was that magcon is happening again, but this time with a different name. And I'm gonna be completely honest, I saw the comments, I googled the name, and I was like, you know what? I could look into this, or I could just sit back and live in blissful ignorance, which was my initial plan until this. So unfortunately for all of us, we are gonna be looking at the second coming of magcon, or better named magcon 2.0. I really cannot believe we're doing this again. So for anybody who didn't see my magcon video and wants just a brief synopsis on what the fuck magcon is and what the fuck this new convention is, the easiest way to describe them is you just have a bunch of young teenage boys that are selling themselves as make-believe boyfriends to their predominantly young female fan base. And in order to be able to sell that and just sell the idea of meeting them, they are also putting on very dysfunctional, very unorganized, very confusing live shows. Of course, before we start the video, we have to do this week's buddy shout out. This week it goes to Michaela Piccolo, and she sent, "My mom checking to make sure I'm not playing Mario Kart DS at 12:56 a.m. on a school night in 2006. If you want to get a sweaty shout out for yourself, all you have to do is subscribe to my channel, which makes you a sweaty, and then follow me on Instagram and DM me your favorite meme of the week on Instagram, and you might get chosen. The only real difference that I can find between the two eras of magcon is that the first one had to do with Vine and the second one has to do with TikTok stars. And unfortunately, the prices are just as ridiculous. For this second era of magcon, we have people paying upwards of $70 to $100 USD to meet boys that lip sync to their phones. Now, if you're wondering why I haven't actually said the name of the second era yet, it's because the name itself is something I already have a problem with. Like, at least magcon, they put it out there, okay? They were completely fine with being known as, listen, this is basically just us charging people to meet and greet these fucking guys. Like, this is it. It was literally called Meet and Greet Convention. But this one is called Lights Out. I don't know why they chose to call it Lights Out. Their logo is a broken light bulb. It makes no sense whatsoever. There's nothing about their show that has anything to do with light bulbs and broken light bulbs. The lights aren't even out during their shows, so I don't really understand why they called it that. Before we get into the actual show, I thought it would be worthwhile to look at the roster, see who's actually putting on the show, get a feel for what the fuck this is, because quite honestly, at face value, it's very confusing. So the first one is Payton Moormeier or Moormeier. I probably botched that either way. But he is a 16-year-old TikTok star. He also has a YouTube channel where he posts vlogs. He posts shorter videos of himself embarrassing himself. Oh my fucking God. You know what? I'm not gonna say anything. I'm not gonna say anything about this video until we actually watch it. I really hope this isn't what I think it is.
The second thing I look for in a girl is a girl who knows how to dress, right?
Girls with good style, if you dress well.
The fourth thing I look for in a girl, I guess this kind of plays on to number three, is that there's that trust in that.
Like trust. Trust.
Trust is very attractive.
Trust. I don't want to date someone that's like 7'2".
I like girls that are short.
Yes.
I like kind of petite girls.
Oh, short kind of.
Sixth thing is if you give really good hugs, you know,
cause I like girls that can cuddle, like,
girls
like a girl who can like really just be herself around me, you know what I mean?
Be yourself personality wise and be yourself appearance wise.
There's always a thing about guys are like insecure if their girlfriend's taller than them, you know, blah blah blah. But like if a girl's like 5'2", 4'11", between their area, it's like then it's just like I don't know how to describe it. It's just like, that's like a perfect height for me.
I love the detail he's going into here. He's like, if you're in between like 4'2 and 5'11, you have like 3 centimeters in between your two eyebrows, your head is about the shape of a grapefruit, then that's a vibe.
If we have the same taste in music, and like, cause if we get in the car, and I'm sitting there skirting around driving, and you're like, change the song.
Do we know for sure if he can even drive?
I am just super attracted to messy buns and I don't know why.
He's been describing YN this entire video. Everybody give up. This man only wants Barbara Palvin or Lily Collins. That's it. Next, we have Chase Hudson, who is also a TikTok star. He's 17, and according to Famous Birthdays, he's amassed more than 2.8 million followers for lip-syncing to songs of artists such as Justin Bieber and Pitbull. Why Pitbull? Beyond TikTok, he also does Instagram videos that seem to only have anything to do with him flipping his hair. Can I get a coke with my rum? 369 girls wanna drink wine. Tell the man not to waste your time. If the man broke, the man he a joke. So you gotta get loose with the henny and the coke. Can you imagine you're this kid's barber and you're like, hey, listen, kid, like just stand still for like 4 more seconds. I just need to do this. And he's like, sir, I am TikTok famous. Next, we have Chase Keith, who is a 16-year-old TikTok star, and he seems to have a side hustle where he's an Instagram brand deal comedian, and by that, I mean that he only does funny Instagram videos when he has a product to push.
Man, I hate when all my friends take my bang. Hey, don't touch my bang. Hey, you could have just asked.
Okay, well, I want a bang as well.
Oh, how could I forget? Delicious. Wow. You can't touch my bang. No, you can't do that. Now, what lesson did we learn today?
Don't ever touch Chase's bang.
That's right, kids. Don't touch my bang, or else I'm gonna come to your house and probably beat you up.
This is a rare kind of video in the sense that I really don't know if they're being sarcastic or not. Like, the overacting seems so over the top that you would think they must be. Like, they're just being like, oh, this is such a cheesy commercial. But also, the overacting is so bad that it almost makes it seem like they're not actually overacting on purpose. They're just that bad.
Oh my God, Greg, so cute. Do you smell that?
Yeah. Rebecca. They're not even trying to hide that they're a bootleg magcon. Like, they're just like, okay, everyone's gonna say it anyway. We might as well jack all their content too. I just wanna know how much Bang is paying him that he would make this many ads, because there are so many of them.
Are you the Bang Angel?
I heard you needed a bang.
I'm ready for the date.
Beyond the Bang energy plugs, he also does Instagram comedy, which, let's be honest here, by nature, this is just gonna be bad.
This is totally me when I see a girl wearing Crocs. Hi, my name's... I know this might be too soon, but do you want to be my wife?
Yo, Chase, look at this. Ready? Make a wish. One, okay. Two, three.
That's not staged at all. Come on, guys. That's completely authentic. Of course, he also has a YouTube channel, and there was one upload that really stuck out amongst the others, and it's called So I Fell in McDonald's.
What? Bro, are you okay?
What do you mean acting game going crazy? You're literally just lying on the ground.
No way.
I get the joke. You made a big mess that somebody getting paid minimum wage is gonna have to clean up so that you could get 30,000 views on a video. Funny. So these are a few of the guys that were on the Lights Out tour. They're the only ones we're gonna look at in specific. Now, before we go into the live show, I just want to remind everybody to aggressively lower their expectations for this, because we're dealing with this side of the internet. When I first started to look into what Lights Out actually is, one of the things that struck me the most was that not even their videographers and their Instagram page could make this event look at all interesting or worth $70 to $100 USD. Don't get me wrong, these videographers and the people who were making these videos to wrap up every single tour date were trying their best, but it is very clear from the videos that they were working with scraps. Most of the videos are just people taking photos with the TikTok stars, and it begs the question, is there anything else happening at this fucking show? And the answer is no. The weird thing is they're not even that secretive about how shitty these events are. One of the videos on their Instagram shows the entire venue, and it looks awful. For starters, this looks like it was filmed in a tent, and then beyond that, they have an aggressive amount of ring lights, balloons, like one bushel of balloons, a long-ass line to meet these guys, and then merch. So it's either, hi, welcome to our event, would you like to spend money, or spend money? A fan even left their experience in one of the comments on their post, and it doesn't look good. I went the other day. Firstly, so many girls kept getting back in line, and by the time it got to my turn, so many of the boys were gone. It was just Chase and the other Chase and Payton and a few. Then, y'all for real had no one to take our pics. I legit tapped on so many girls saying, hi, can you please take a pic of me and blank? I'm just gonna glaze over the Chase and the other Chase comment because obviously the more pressing issue is these organizers were charging upwards of $100 USD and didn't even have people set to take these pictures. Before you lose all hope though, there's a performance section.
Yes! Am I vlogging?
Yeah.
Hi guys, I'm vlogging right now. You know what is up? Well, I got
Harry doesn't deserve this shit. This is offensive. Let me get this straight. These guys charged $100 USD to play One Direction karaoke and they got away with it? So far, all they've done is just walked in circles on stage and fixed their hair.
Parents, mom, dad, whatever the relationship is, all the siblings, yep, thank y'all so much again. This really means the world to everybody.
Parents, guardians, whoever the hell it was that was over 18 that bought your tickets, yes, we love you. But more specifically, we love your money. So clearly from the footage, it seems that the only things that these guys did on stage as a performance was walked around in circles, fixed their hair, called each other baby, took people's phones and like talked to their phones, and then gave people high fives. Actually, I'm so sorry, I almost forgot about this. Can someone just please explain to me what is so amazing about what he just did? Like, I don't understand. Is this the point in my life where I just start to not understand what is cool and hip and in with the times? Like, what is the, I can't even do it. Hold on, just give me a second here. Like, what is the point of this? I look like an idiot. Seeing as their performances are, for lack of a better word, pathetic, their meet and greets take the center stage when it comes to these actual events. On the guy's end, they're being so overly intimate with their fans. Like, what if one day they just don't want to do it? Or what if they get a girlfriend and their girlfriend isn't okay with it? And like, where is the line? Like, I just don't understand. And then on the fan side, they don't realize the managers are allowing this kind of shit because they know that the closer that the fans are to the TikTok stars and the more they feel like they're actually dating them and they're doing boyfriend-girlfriend things with them, the more money they're gonna spend on them. And it's fucking manipulative. I think it's also worth mentioning that beyond just getting a regular ticket or VIP, you could also get, it was called like a dinner, I don't even know, it was like a date and a dinner or something, and essentially you could buy a dinner date with said TikTok star, and you would have one TikTok star with, I don't know how many people were allowed to have a date with that TikTok star that night, but it would be multiple people, so you'd have 10 fans having dinner with one guy. As outrageous as all of this seems to me personally, and I'm sure to some of you as well, there are people that are very big fans of these TikTok stars for whatever reason, and of course, when people are fans of something, there comes fanfiction. Me and my boyfriend Payton made our way to the airport. We were headed to Orlando, Florida for Playlist Live. I think that's where Playlist Live is this year. We were both going to be attending for content creators. How long a flight do you think it's gonna be? Payton asked, getting frustrated at how slow the lines were moving. I'm not sure. maybe at least a few hours, I replied, taking his hand in mine. After a good few minutes of waiting, we made our way to the front desk and did what we had to do. Why did they word it like that? It makes them sound like they committed a murder instead of just validating their passports. We eventually made our way to our gate and sat down. While we were waiting, we did some Snapchat pics and vids, just telling people where we were and what we were doing. We went to go grab some snacks and drinks before they called our gate to depart. Once we headed back to our gate, first class was already being called. I'm so excited to go to Florida, I tailed Payton, squealing a bit. He chuckled at my excitement, handing our tickets to the lady. You both sit down. The seat next to you was empty, so Payton put his feet on the chair. I'm tired, YN. Can I take a nap on you? He says, lifting his armrest. Yeah, sure, you say, as he lays his head on your lap. After a few minutes of sitting there, you start to run your fingers through his light brown hair. You hear a sighing content. That feels good. Keep doing it, he mumbles. Okay, but only if you let me ride your skateboard, you say, letting out a giggle. He is so obsessed with his skateboard. He won't let anyone ride it, not even his closest friend, Chase. All right, deal, he says. Through the whole flight, he slept while you played with his hair. It was probably the best flight you ever took. I love what the bottom the writer put, I'm not sure how to feel about this. Like, yeah, same, me neither. Late nights with Chase Keith. It's a Friday night, and all I want to do is see my boyfriend Chase at the beach. But having parents that are very strict with boys means you can't, one, tell them you have a boyfriend, two, ever hang out with anyone on the weekend nights because boys could be out there and try to hurt you, which is true if you're walking around dark alleyways in NYC in skimpy LaGrange. You text your parents and tell them you're going to sleep, but you lock your door, get changed, and sneak out your window. Oh, there's like an option. We can choose an outfit. Let's go with number one. You put on this swimsuit under your outfit. Oh, so like we don't get to choose here? We're just gonna wear a fucking curtain? After you grab your bag and put a few things in it, charger, extra clothes, etc., run down your street and into a CVS, you immediately text Chase and tell him to come get you. After a few minutes, he pulled up to the building in an Uber and you got in. Hey, cupcake. I love the author's notes. Ew, I'm cringing. Hey, cookie. You kissed him on his cheek and you two set off to the docks in the Uber. You immediately run off the coast of the warm Los Angeles beach water on a hot July evening with the love of your life. Wow. I'm so single, Caden. Please love me. Chase ran after you. He caught up to you and turned you around, but after he did, he spun you around. He leaned in, but you took the perfect chance to play hard to get. Ooh. So you ran to the sand, put your stuff down, took off your clothes, shirts, pants, shoes. You keep the swimsuit on. LOL. Of course he went after you, but after he caught you again, you kissed him, and of course being the absolute dad he is, he did the most sweet thing ever, and he dipped you and kissed you longer. After a few more minutes, you both wanted to go back to either of your houses, but you knew your parents would literally disown you. So you called your mom, she didn't pick up, so you left a voicemail. Hey mom, it's YN. You probably already know that, but whatever. I'm not at home, I'm not asleep, and I'm not going to lie. I did sneak out of my window, and I went to see my boyfriend Cheese. Chase, why did I just call him Cheese? I am okay, I'm not being harmed because Chase loves me and I love him, but I'm gonna spend the night at his house and I will be okay. I'll be home very late tomorrow or not at all for a while. Bye, love you. Listen, mom, I'm either gonna be home tomorrow or never again, so do with that information as you will. I will say there's one thing that the Lights Out Boys have brought to my attention that I did not know existed, and it's imagines that consists solely of just text messages that you would hope to receive from one of the guys from the Lights Out tour group. YN bold, Chase not bold. I hate school. I hate everything. I'm coming right now. Oh, you sure are. How the fuck are you so dirty all the damn time? Why can't we have a normal combo ever? You started it, baby girl. You know what I mean. Stop putting fucking words in my mouth. Alrighty, why don't I put something up? Am I allowed to read this? I don't really want to read this. Because they're really young. I think that's enough for today. There's one that I want to bring up solely for the first couple sentences. It's called, Oh Baby, It's Cold in LA. And it says, I'm a little bit shy. I'm a little bit right on time. You were on your way to Starbucks, where you and your boyfriend Chase would be having a date. Do you want to know what you're wearing to this date? You're wearing this. This 2011 bitch is back again. Infinity scarf, high boots, green combat jacket thing. It hasn't died. It's been like 10 years, guys. Can we please move on to somebody else? Some of these imagines have even been turned into YouTube videos. He said, I love you too, and you guys went to his house and you text your mom you were at a friend's house. You and Payton went up to his room and you guys hung out until 5. And then you said bye and kissed him and said bye to his mom, Miss Moormeier. Home. YM, so you're hanging out with Payton or dating him? Rory, what do you mean? YM, Joanne told me you and Payton were hanging out today. Rory, yeah, we were. Why? Because you said a friend's but not who. Oh, how do you know Payton's mom? YM, me and Peyton's mom were friends in high school and got pregnant at the same time, so you and Peyton have the same birthday. Your thoughts? That makes me love him more. Ugh, why is he so cute? End of thoughts. Morning, you wake up and take a shower and put this on. I've got like a rainbow moment. You grab your backpack and go to Peyton's house and get him and walk him to his bus stop holding hands. You guys sit together and you guys start to kiss again. You guys stopped kissing after 2 minutes away from school. These emojis are killing me. Skip to lunch. You and Peyton go to his table and hold hands. While you're going to get rid of your tray, Jaylee comes up and punches you in the face, but you dodge it and pop her right in the face. She was knocked out cold. After school, you and Pay go to In-N-Out. You're telling me we're just gonna glaze over the domestic that just happened 2 minutes ago? That's it? The worst part is Lights Out isn't even the only tour of its kind running as we speak. There's another one called Boys of Summer Tour 2019, and this shit takes the cake for the ugliest Instagram I've ever seen in my entire life. Who designed these? Somebody just slapped a bunch of photos on a blue background and went, music! Anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed this video and this exploration into MagCon 2.0. Let's all collectively pray that this is the last phase of MagCon we will ever see, because this is just starting to get a little bit concerning. If you did enjoy the video, you can give it a like and subscribe to the channel. If you want to follow me outside of YouTube, you can follow me on Instagram and Twitter, which are both Casey Aonso, and otherwise, I will see you guys in the next one.